So I have some interesting information about Alzheimer's and your hormones. Check this out. And this is all based on a recent book that I got, and I'm going to put a link down below. But you never, ever, ever see Alzheimer's in kids or young people. It's always in older people. So if we take a look at one big difference between the young and the old, we have a hormonal shift. We have a significant drop in estrogen. Between 35 years old and 50, there's a 35% decrease. Progesterone really takes a dive down 75% between ages 35 and 50. You also have a decrease in DHEA, which is a stress hormone, and also a decrease in pregnenolone, and a decrease in growth hormone, and a decrease in D3. And D3 is considered a hormone, simply because our skin becomes older and you just can't absorb vitamin D like you used to. But there is a spike in these two hormones, luteinizing hormone and follicle-stimulating hormone. See this after menopause. So that's interesting. The author of this book talked about the relationship between luteinizing hormone, okay, this one right here. And by the way, both of these hormones trigger the gonads, the ovaries and the testicles. So it increases estrogen, progesterone, and testosterone. These are spiked because it's trying to stimulate these and it's not working, so the feedback loop keeps elevating these two hormones. So the author found this relationship between increased luteinizing hormone and Alzheimer's. Now the author also found in another paper that cigarette smoking and ibuprofen decreases this hormone, and there's some evidence that it does decrease the risk of Alzheimer's. Now, we're not recommending these two things, but that's an interesting connection. If we take a look at the drug Lupron, Lupron normally is used for endometriosis, fibroids, decreasing risk of breast cancer, decreasing risk of prostate cancer. But there's also some data that it decreases the risk of Alzheimer's. And this is interesting because normally these things would come from excess amount of estrogen. But apparently the effects that are created from this drug has more to do with luteinizing hormone than estrogen. So one of the big problems with Lupron is the side effects. However, there are other natural things that can also lower luteinizing hormone without side effects. So one being melatonin. Melatonin is considered the clock hormone because it helps regulate sleep. It's stimulated by darkness and it helps you get into a deep sleep. It also has a huge effect over your immune system and it's a powerful antioxidant. But it also can decrease luteinizing hormone, which then can help decrease the risk of Alzheimer's. Now, if you're going to read this book, you're going to find that the main effect between melatonin and decreasing symptoms of Alzheimer's is mainly in women, okay? However, if you increase the dose of melatonin higher in men than you do in women, you can see some good effects of decreasing the risk of Alzheimer's. So I want to give you the protocol, then you can read the book and get more details. This is what is recommended. If you're a female, you'd want to take 75 milligrams of melatonin. Now, realize that when you buy melatonin, it usually comes in 3 milligrams. Okay, that's very, very small. So you can imagine how many pills you'd have to take. So what you'd want to do is gradually work up to this. Start with 3 milligrams for 1 week, then double it to 6 for 1 week, and then double it to 12 another week, and gradually go up to this amount right here to create this effect. Now, if you're a man, the suggestion is that you would take 120 milligrams of melatonin at night before you go to sleep. The next thing that's recommended is pregnenolone, 300 milligrams per day. And because in Alzheimer's patients, there's a diminished capacity to use glucose as fuel, you want to use ketones for fuel. One way to do it is to take MCT oil, about 3 teaspoons per day spread out. And of course, I'm going to always recommend you do keto as well as fasting, okay? I'll put some links down below if you're new to my channel, but it's very, very important to do that because if we can increase ketones, we can actually activate more of the brain. Also, it's less damaging than glucose. Okay, exercise has been shown to create some really good effects in Alzheimer's patients. So the combination of all these things together will create a nice dent into this condition right here. Now, of course, check with your doctor before applying any of this information. This is just for your education and to show you some interesting links between what happens with your hormones and Alzheimer's. Thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.